welcome. It's Caleb here from the Game Glyph, and I've got Scott Squatch over here, who's nice enough to give me some of his time, and I'm going to ask him some questions real quick, and he's going to fire back as quickly as possible.
I'm going to ramble and make up words. Yeah. It'll be great.
Okay, so what is your favorite game?
Sneasel Slorp.
Sneasel Slorp?
Yeah.
What system?
For the Sneasel Slorp 2.
My favorite.
Silent Hill 2 is my favorite game of all time.
Okay.
Atmosphere, the creatures.
Yeah.
They're not a zombie, a ghost.
No.
You know, it's all very
weird.
Yeah. And the music.
Yeah.
The guy that created, I don't want to screw his name up. I'm not even going to say it.
Yeah.
The guy that made the music for Silent Hill. I have his autograph on a soundtrack, and I'm drawing a blank.
He did a great job,
Akira
though.
Akira Yamaoka. There we go.
That's
his name.
Okay.
I saved myself slightly there.
What's the true ending in that game? Is that like, the true ending's like when there's like the UFO, you realize it's UFOs?
Well.
Right? They're like UFOs, ghosts, demons, like alternate realities all at the same time.
Yeah, well there's in the Silent Hill universe, there's endings where a dog is in the game, you know, or UFOs, or I guess the true ending is whatever you want it to be.
Yeah, it's got that Twin Peaks thing.
Exactly. Because the Silent Hill universe sort of like, it's related, but it's different for each person because it's a part, it's like in them.
It's like how you play it, how it's experience. Okay, this is the main one I wanted to ask you. Where'd you come up with your name?
Scott Squatch?
Yeah, yeah.
So I worked for Vans and I toured and traveled.
Really?
And one of the first tours I was ever on, I was trying to be cool. I was like 19. I was trying to have a nickname.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it was something to do like with a Sasquatch, but one of the guitar players like, no, that's stupid.
Oh.
And I was like, okay.
Guitar player.
Yeah, he's like, no, Scott Squatch, much better than whatever it was.
Than
like,
anything you're thinking.
Yeah.
Only because he said it though, right?
Exactly.
Right.
I was like, I guess it's Scott Squatch now, thanks.
Yeah, so there it is, and it stuck, and that's,
That was about 10 years ago now, roughly right around like 11 years.
So what did you do with bands?
Everything.
Really?
I worked, the biggest thing I did was I worked for Korn. I worked for Korn for 8 years.
Really?
I was a personal assistant.
How was Jonathan Davis as a person?
Nice.
Is he a nice dude?
Yeah.
Is he quiet?
He's not you don't hang out
right,
with him.
Yeah,
no.
To A-list.
Well, he has a very like subdued personality.
Okay.
So he kind of does his own thing.
Yeah.
And you know, but he's very friendly and very nice. Monkey and Head, the two guitar players.
Yeah.
That's who I worked for
and spent
the time around. And then other bands, I worked briefly for Five Finger Death Punch.
Okay.
I don't do coke and drink a lot, so I just didn't fit in there.
Yeah.
And then I worked for a record label called Emotional Siphon, which was owned by one of the guitar players from Korn. So I did a lot.
That's awesome. Do you play?
I played bass when I was younger.
Delicious bass?
I still have a bass that sits in the closet.
Yeah.
Like once a year I come out, you know, bring it out.
Slap it a bit.
Yep.
That's cool.
Only way to play bass with these two fingers.
Yeah.
Can't use a pick. Yeah.
Yeah, picking is faking, right?
Not correct.
Well, that's cool. You all, like RGT 85, you also have a musical background.
Yes.
As do I, which is kind of an interesting correlation. What was the game that like that took you from just casually being interested in gaming to like making you become like a gamer, like a hardcore gamer that you are?
100% Mario 3, because I remember the kid across the street when I was 3 or 4 years old, or whatever.
Yeah.
Having the Nintendo, playing it at his house, and then going home and telling my mom or dad about, you need to get me Mario. I didn't have a Nintendo at that point. I only had Atari.
Right.
And that was a pass down from my brother.
Yeah, yeah.
So that was that was the first time I ever was like, I need this.
I must have this.
Yeah. Not there's something sitting there I'm going to play or whatever.
That's a good one, actually. That's a fantastic game. I have to look at my thing here. Oh yeah, what made you go from being a gamer and all that to actually starting a YouTube channel?
I've been on YouTube for 10 years. And it's changed over the years. It went from Halloween props to the touring stuff.
Right.
And then the gaming stuff kind of mixed in when I started to see that people would care about what games you own or talking about them.
It's interesting.
Pete Dore on YouTube, who I think, did the very first game room tour on YouTube. And then other channels, like when Game Chaser started out, that got me more into, you know, like, I think people would like to see this.
So. That's a great show. I love Game Chaser. Yeah. It's really fun. I mean, who would you say was, like, your biggest influence? Probably Game Chaser?
Yes, and Pat the NES one, because he did a show about going to flea markets, Flea Market Madness, and that is sort of where...
awesome show.
Yeah. And that's where... but he does the, like, the resellers are terrible aspect.
Right.
And, you know, there's, like, an alert that'll pop up.
Yeah.
And I wanted to show that there are sellers out there that are... that are not a 50, 70-year-old man that just, I know that game's worth money, so here, you know.
Yeah, the cranbones, they call it the industry.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, interesting.
I want to show that people actually collect or talk about games, you know.
Yeah. Well, who would you say is, like, the one that really pilgrimed all the gaming YouTube? I mean, I probably already know what your answer to me, but I just want to hear it from your mouth.
I mean, everyone's answer is Angry Video Game Nerd.
Yay! Have you met James Rowe?
I did. Oh, it's fine. Well, I don't drink, but he drank, and we took a couple photos and sang karaoke.
Okay.
So that was at too many games.
Yeah, he's definitely like a person that, I mean, a lot of people that start out, like, you can tell it's like why they do what they do, you know? People like him, Jotron, and like that kind of stuff, you know?
I guess because my channel and what I do is more about, like, the collecting aspect, it, you know, he was a big influence, but probably more of the door and that kind of stuff that were, I don't know, he might have started the same exact time, Johnny Millennium's another one that I was really into.
He's a good one too.
But that Angry Video Game, James.
Yeah.
They might have started basically the same year or same, you know.
I don't know, I remember that, I think the Angry Video Game Nerd started kind of pre-YouTube.
Yeah, he had his own
Cinemassacre website.
Exactly.
Released his nerd video as a joke, and then it kind of just, I know you know this whole story. Took off from there.
I've watched a few of his videos.
Yeah, they're great. Let me ask you this for a young, not myself, of course, I'm obviously older, but for anyone starting a YouTube channel.
It's gray.
Yeah, a little gray in there. What would you give, like, advice to someone that's kind of like trying to start their own YouTube channel?
I mean, the stupid answer, don't do it. No.
Don't do it, man.
Oh, just make fun videos.
Yeah.
And if you're not having fun making them, take a break.
Yeah.
Or, you know, I've had friends that started a YouTube channel, try to do a collaboration with everybody possible.
Right. Yeah.
Just put full force into it for a year, mm-hmm. and then we're like, oh my god,
burnout.
Yeah. You can't do it thinking that you'll make money. If you make money on it, cool.
Yeah, I would never imagine, like, you could not start that industry out just like, I'm gonna instantly start making money.
Yeah, I personally know maybe less than 10 YouTubers. You know, friends of mine or whatever that actually do it as a job.
Yeah.
Everyone else has their, you know,
their
own job. Even people that have 300,000 to 400,000 subscribers, right. some of those still have their own job.
Yeah, it's kind of like the music industry, right? Where it's like you don't want to do it for the wrong reasons, because then it just looks contrived and you look desperate. And I see that a lot.
Unless you wear cool makeup.
All the time.
Then that's fine.
Which I don't. I mean, I'm wearing some foundation right now.
Well, we have a light glare.
Yeah, we knew that was going to happen. Yeah. So. Yeah, well, okay, well, that was most of my questions.
Eye boogers real quick.
Yeah, get them. Get those keys in on the eye boogers real quick. Here's some rapid fire questions, rapid fire answers you probably like. What would be your desert island game? Your dessert island game.
Obviously game. Something that I could play over and over and over again. Let's say, like, Gremlins 2.
Gremlins 2, really?
Yeah.
It's like a 35-minute game.
I know I can beat it, but the music, I think... Games for me, for some reason, music. I get really tied into. If
Absolutely.
I can whistle along, like, to Batman on NES or something.
Oh, that's like my favorite game ever.
Yeah. Those, if it's a full package, the music, the controls are tight.
Right.
And it helps if I can actually beat it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it doesn't hurt.
So,
yeah.
Since I can beat that one, that would be a good pick.
It's about Guilty Pleasure game. Game that you hate to admit that you love.
The story based, like, Japanese graphic novel.
Yeah.
Oh
no.
That is not how my face looked when I was talking right now.
It was. Bop, 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 bop. Yeah. So it was
the graphic novel style Japanese games where
a lot of
times they're like love stories.
What was the one that's like about the dads? It's like date your dad or something like that. You know what I'm talking about?
No.
Where it's all of the whole game's principle is based around like dating dads.
Well,
Dad Simulator. Dad Dating Simulator.
I haven't played that one myself.
Yes.
Dad sent me their DS on the Nintendo DS. Yeah. Check it out.
Yeah, I don't think that's real, but it's on the phone for sure.
Yeah.
Okay, what about what's your most hated game? What's the game that pisses you off? Rage quit, break, throw it, whatever, you know.
I mean, in the fact of breaking copies, we've broken 50 plus copies of Shaq Fu.
Shaq Fu on Sega Genesis or Super Nintendo?
Oh, all of Game Gear. Genesis, yeah. And
oh,
it's
God,
not
Game Gear version of Shaq Fu.
Yeah, it's not even that it's probably, you know, deserving of that many broken copies, but after a certain point, you just gotta focus on one game to hate.
Yeah, that's a terrible game. What do you think about the revitalization of Shaq Fu?
We're still waiting for the game, right?
Are you gonna buy it?
No. Well, I mean, if I get a copy that's physical, you know, I'll smash it.
Yeah.
But
you should smash all of them, just to help everyone.
That's the goal. That's the only reason why the Kickstarter happened, is just to break these copies.
You should start an anti-Kickstarter for that.
We tweeted at Shaq, saying, you know, why are you doing this? We're just going to smash your game. He never replied, but maybe he'll.
Why, Shaq? Why is the earth flat, Shaq? So you dropped two bombs. You dropped the bomb of releasing one of the worst games ever made, and that you believe the earth is flat.
I didn't know he believed the earth was flat.
He's a flat earther. They got supporters all around the globe. I mean, everyone knows that. But yeah.
Well, on the top and the bottom of it.
Oh, yeah. Well, outside the ice wall where the frost giants, you know, come from and all that kind of stuff. Did you think your channel would make it like where it is now? Because how many subscribers do you have at this exact time?
I just checked like 10 minutes ago. I'm 35 away from 50,000.
That's insane.
I can't get to 50,000 for some
You'll never get to 50,000. No, you will. I absolutely will.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm hoping this weekend, I'm hoping by the end of this weekend, I can pass that.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
So what was the question?
Did you think you would get that far doing what you did?
No. I remember taking a walk with my wife at a park. Mm-hmm. When we were at the point of the channel of being like the Halloween videos, and I was just maybe gonna do some game related stuff, I had said, man, wouldn't it be like crazy if we could, you know, get maybe, you know, a couple hundred views, you know, each video?
That would be crazy.
You know, or if each video could make like $5.
Yeah.
You know, I could, I don't know, that would make it, you know, so much, you know, more interesting and keeping this as like, you know,
you justify doing it almost more that way.
And then like 6 months later, it was way past that.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I did some pretty great success. Great success.
Thanks, yes. Yeah. I mean, it's a very niche thing.
It is, yeah.
And to kind of go on with that question, I don't really think my channel will go much farther.
Really?
I think there's a sort of a cap. In the sense of if you don't start changing what you do, like there's only a certain amount of people that care to watch game hunting videos at a garage sale.
No, I mean, Game Chaser seems to be steadily growing their subscriber base, and they even have spin-off channels like Ape and Eric and stuff like that.
I say this being some of my best friends are the Game Chasers, but they have slowly gained subscribers.
Yeah.
I mean, they just passed 100,000.
Yeah, they've been at it for a long time, too.
Yeah, I mean, and they've been doing it forever. And same thing is like they are making it other channels because they know I've had this conversation with them. They know that there's only a certain amount of people that are going to be interested in watching.
But they switched it up. Like they did this video recently that was hilarious. It was like a montage of like various members of Game Chasers, like their worst moments.
Oh yeah.
And that was hilarious.
Yeah.
It was just like all the extra footage. And I mean, do you plan on doing anything else like reviews or anything more intricate like that?
I've found what fits into my life style and what I enjoy. And I think I found, like I said, the audience that wants to watch that.
Naturally, organically.
If I ever go back, if for some reason I get a phone call one day that says, hey, do you want to come back and work for Korn? You know, then
Korn still exists?
Yes. But I might start filming, you know, a different aspect, but at least for where I'm at right now, I think I'm good.
Okay, well, that's awesome.
Game Chaser also have a new channel, the Paranormal Hunters.
Yeah, I saw that, which is like that really interests me because I'm really into that kind of stuff.
I will
as
be
well.
In a future episode.
Really? So are you into that kind of thing?
It was fun. We climbed the mountain at like 1 o'clock in the morning in Arizona, looking
Paranormal
for UFOs.
Hunters.
Yep.
You believe in UFOs?
I am one of those where I would not be surprised if something else was out there.
You're agnostic about it.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
I mean, my name's Scott Squatch, so I kind of, you know, I hope that Sasquatches were somehow real.
You do have a predisposition to the Yeti, don't you?
I do.
Yeah.
The hair, the fur.
Yeah.
I do a really convincing,
the wall.
I can't think of the guy that really original took the picture. Anyways, that classic photo. Yeah,
that's great. Well, I really appreciate you taking the time to be on the channel and stuff like that, and hopefully you had fun out here in Greenville, little tiny Greenville.
I did. It's weird. I one-day conventions I really haven't done.
Yeah.
So it's weird flying in yesterday and then having to leave at 7 a.m. tomorrow.
Right, it's
morning.
Kind of like a hammer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I need to go back in.
Yeah.
I would like to go back in.
Well, thank you so much, man. I appreciate it. Yeah. We're going to actually go to our panel, but...
Yes.
All right. Yeah, well, I'll edit that later.
We're going to panel. Bye.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Will you just never blink and just stare at me? Okay, you can blink one eye. That's okay.
And lick your lips.
Yes.